Now, there are two parts in the U.S. Code, or you could say the Federal Food, Drug, and Cosmetic Act, where we see definitions for adulterated and misbranded. And these tend to be the two things that food safety professionals really should have some familiarity with. So let's take a look at what those are. Now, I tend to joke and ask, hey, do you know the definition of adulterated? Of course not. It's two pages long. What about misbranded? Okay, that's even longer. So if you are going to be reading warning letters, or I should really say, yeah, warning letters would be one place they pop up. They'll tend to reference the specific section and subsection where the facility is not in compliance, or maybe it's an importer. So if you pop open 21 USC 342, here you can scroll down and see the full definition of adulterated. Now, I'd normally focus on A, because A includes those things that are, it addresses filth and things injurious to health. There are many other things covered in A. But scroll down to the bottom and you'll see at the very end of the definition, they talk about sanitary transportation. Now with misbranded, we tend to, at least for food safety professionals, we'll scroll down to W. Section W focuses on major food allergens. So this is where if you fail to declare a major food allergen, your food is misbranded. And there are other kinds of misbranded. Misbranding, as you can see in the definition, is very long. And normally, if you scroll to the top, you'll see like A, B, and C. We tend to think of those, you know, there's a great Curb Your Enthusiasm where a guy opens a bag of mixed nuts and it says there's almonds in there, and he opens it and there are no almonds. And he feels like he's been ripped off. So yes, that may be a kind of misbranding if you say there are almonds in there and there are no almonds. A lot of people ask me, well, what about, can we just declare all the major food allergens and just deal with it that way, avoiding any chance of misbranding? Well, actually, you'd be engaged in misbranding there too, because you'd be misleading the consumer. You'd be giving them the impression that there's, you know, like lobster in your mixed nuts. That's a little introduction to the U.S. Code, the definition of adulterated and misbranded, incredibly useful for anybody in food safety to know. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching.